Okay guys, in the frontal view, what we can see here, we can see the frontal bone, we can see the two nasal bone, we can see here the maxillary pier, we can see here the lacrimal, we can see both sides, the zygomatic, we can see here the vomer, the septum of the nasal cavity, we can see both sides, the inferior nasal concha, we can see here the mandible. Now I will talk about the marking. We can see in the frontal bone, we can see superciliary arches both sides, the depression in between the superciliary arches, glabella. We can see supraorbital foramen and notch. We can see here the suture between the frontal and the nasal. We call that frontonasal suture. And the intersection here, we call that the nasion. We can see here the maxillary bone is making a joint with the frontal, we call that frontomaxillary suture. We got here the nasomaxillary suture. Between the two nasal bone, internasal suture. Laterally, we got here frontozygomatic suture, zygomaticomaxillary suture, and here on the maxillary portion that we got here, infraorbital foramen. If you're looking inside the orbit, we are having inside the orbit the optic canal, we are having the supraorbital fissure and the infraorbital fissure and the lacrimal canal. Looking at the maxillary bone, we got here the infraorbital foramen. Maxillary bone and nasal bone are making the boundary of the nasal opening. We call that piriform aperture, superiorly by the nasal bone, laterally and inferiorly by the maxillary bone. On the maxilla, we are also having here both sides, the nasal crest and nasal spine in the middle. It is having the teeth. We call that maxillary arch of teeth. And here we are having the alveolar process of the maxilla. Zygomatic bone is having the, literally we can see the zygomatic bone is having the very small foramen. We call that zygomaticofacial foramen, only letting the nerve to pass through there. Now we are talking about the inferior, the mandible, that is having the mental protuberance, mental crust, alveolar process of the mandible, and alveolar arch for the teeth. We got here the mental foramen. We are having the oblique line here. Okay. We are going to talk about the superior view of the skull, in which we can see the calvaria. We can see here the frontal bone, which is a single bone. And here we can see the two parietal bone. We can see here the occipital bone. And the both side, we can see here the temporal bone. So let's talk about the suture between the frontal and the parietal bone. Between the frontal and the parietal bone, at this place we are having the suture, we known as the frontal suture. Between the two parietal bone, we are having the suture, we call it as the sagittal suture. Between the occipital and the parietal bone, we are having the suture, we call that lambdoid suture. So talk about the intersection of the frontal and the sagittal suture. This point we call that brigma. The intersection between the lambdoid and the sagittal, we call that lambda. Here you can see the bone that is coming in the suture. This kind of bone, we call that a Wormerian bone or sutural bone. So now we are looking at the skull from the lateral view. What we can see in the lateral view, front we can see the frontal bone. We can see here the frontal bone. We can see the parietal. We can see the temporal bone, occipital bone. And we can see the mandible and part of the zygomatic and the maxilla too. So we can see here the suture that is mainly talk about the temporal bone. This is the squamous part of the temporal bone. So squamous part is making the suture with the parietal. At this part we call that squamous suture, and it is making the suture between the sphenoid and the squamous. We call that sphenosquamous suture. We get here frontosphenoidal suture. We got here parietosphenoidal suture. Here we got the zygomatic process of the temporal bone, which is making the joint with the zygomatic bone. So we call that zygomatico temporal suture. Here we got the frontal and the zygomatic. We call that frontozygomatical suture. We can see here literally that the mandible is making the joint with the temporal bone. So this is the largest synovial joint in the skull. We call that temporomandibular joint. Temporomandibular joint. And this part that we can see here, the mastoid part of the temporal bone, and the mastoid part here is making the joint with the parietal and also with the occipital. So we call that parietomastoid or occipitomastoid suture respectively. From the lateral view, we are going to see here, in the lateral view, we are having here the pterion, which is actually the junction of the four bone, frontal, parietal, temporal, and the sphenoidal. Clinically, it is important because it is the weak point. The backside here, we can see here the three bones intersection here, that the parietal, occipital, and the temporal. This point known as the estrion. So when we are talking about from the posterior view, in the posterior view, we can see here the mainly the occipital bone and temporal and the parietal bone. So on the occipital bone, what we are having here, valley, on the occipital bone, what we are having here, the elevation, what we call that the inion, and we are having external occipital protuberance. The both side, we are having the superior and inferior nuchal line. Thank you.